Standard 6, lesson number 10, Ancient India, Cultural. Language. There are an interrupted literary tradition in ancient India. This literature was produced in Sanskrit, Ardhavagadi, Pali and Tamil.
What do ancient literature include? It included religious literature, treatises on grammar, epics, play, stories, etc.
Sangam literature. Sangam means gathering of learned men. Sangam literature is collection of such learned men's gathering. For students, one can acquire knowledge by reading Sangam literature. Name two well-known epics, Shilpadikaram and Manimekhalai. What do we learn from Sangam literature? We learn about the political and social life in South India. So student, we know the two well-known epics are Shilpadikaram and Manimekhalai, and social and political life in South India can be learned from the Sangam literature. Next literature we are going to see is about the religious literature. Okay, the important texts include Agam Granth, Tipitak and Bhagavad Gita. So these are the three religious literature text. Okay students, let's know about the languages. Okay, so here first language is given is about Prakrit. The Prakrit are the group of vernacular middle Indo-Aryan language. Which language it is? Indo-Aryan language. It is used in India from around 3rd century BCE to the 8th century CE. The term Prakrit is usually applied to the middle period. Samajh mein aaya? It is applied to the middle period of middle Indo-Aryan language, excluding earlier inscription and the later Pali. So this Prakrit language later is converted into Pali. Okay, now the question arises, is Pali and Prakrit same? Kya ye dono bhashaye same hai? Nahi students, these two languages are different. Let's see. Pali and Prakrit are included into the Middle Indo-Aryan languages. Therefore, these two languages are not same, but they were same as the common language used by common people in ancient time. समझ में आया आप लोगों को? जिस तरह से हम अपनी बातों को एक्सप्रेस करने के लिए किसी भाषा का प्रयोग करते हैं, उसी तरह से हमारे एंशंट एंसेस्टर्स जो हैं वो पाली या प्राकृत भाषा में ओके तो बातें करते थे. सो दीज आर द टू लैंग्वेजेस, दे आर नॉट सेम. पाली अलग है और प्राकृत अलग है, बट हाँ ये दोनों भाषाएं जो है वो मिडिल इंडो आर्यन लैंग्वेजेस है. ओके, पाली इज इन एक्चुअलिटी इज अ मिडिल इंडो आर्यन और इंडो यूरोपियन लैंग्वेज क्लोजली रिलेटेड वैदिक संस्कृत. प्राकृत मीन्स अ कॉमन लैंग्वेज विच was usually spoken but hardly written, whereas Sanskrit was refined, perfected, spoken and written. Prakrit speaker could not read or speak Vedic Sanskrit, which was the core language of the day among the elite. It was a language that Buddha spoke and taught in the exclusively after rejecting he rejected the Vedas. Vedic rituals, languages, Vedic Sanskrit and Vedic culture, he also stated his teachings were for everyone, not only a selected few. That is whatever he is teaching, it is not for the selected people, it is for everybody. All men are equal in front of his teaching. So nobody is special. Okay? So what is this? Saur Shreni. Saur Shreni Prakrit was a middle Indo-Aryan language and dramatic Prakrit. Saur Shreni was a chief language used in drama in northern medieval India. Khape? Northern medieval India. This language was used over there. Apakrit language of North India used in large part of Jain canon is Ardha Magadhi Bhasha. Okay, so this language is the Apakrit language of North India. Our next is Maharashtri. It is also a Prakrit language of the region Maharashtra in western India. So student, why I am telling you about the different types of Prakrit language? Because Jain Agam Granth is written in this three Prakrit language, that is Ardha Magadhi, Saur Shreni and Maharashtri. So Jain Agam Granth is collection of teaching of Mahavira in Prakrit language. Okay, so which are the Prakrit language? Yes, Ardha Magadhi, Saur Shreni and Maharashtri. So these are the three Prakrit language in which the teachings of Vardhaman Mahavira is written. Vardhaman Mahavir ne jo bhi kuch sikhaya tha, jo bhi acche मैसेजेस दिए थे, वो सारे के सारे इन प्राकृतिक भाषाओं में जैन आगम ग्रंथ में उपलब्ध हैं. सो दिस ग्रंथ इज द बिगेस्ट ग्रंथ के विच कंटेन द टीचिंग्स ऑफ महावीरा इन प्राकृतिक लैंग्वेज. आई रिपीट, इट इज इन प्राकृतिक लैंग्वेज. अपभ्रंश. What is this, students? Apavramsha is a language, okay, literary language of final phase of the Middle Indo-Aryan language, when Prakrit languages were formalized by literary use. Their variation came to be known as Apavramsha. Jo changes hue, language bante bante jo bhi changes hue, phir wo jo hai वो अपभ्रंश कहलाने लगा. ठीक है. सो डिस्पाइट दिस क्लोज रिलेशनशिप, स्कॉलर जनरली ट्रीट अपभ्रंश एंड नॉन लिटररी प्राकृत सेपरेटली. ओके, सो दे स्टार्टेड ट्रीटिंग दिस टू लैंग्वेजेस सेपरेटली. सो हियर द ग्रेट लिटररी वर्क like Mahapuranas and biographies, stories, etc. are available in these language. What did Siddhasen Divakar write? Siddhasen Divakar wrote Samai Sutta, that is a small work in Prakrit language on jurisprudence. What is the meaning of jurisprudence, students? It is a theory of philosophy law. Okay, एक theory है philosophy law के ऊपर. So that has been done in Prakrit language by Siddhasen Divakar. Story of Rama in Paumcharya. Yes students, story of Rama in Paumcharya, it is the poetic work in Prakrit and it is written by Vimal Suri. It is written by Vimal Suri. Haribhadra Suri's work Samurai Ichikah Udyotan Suri Kuval Yamala Kah.
Pitika.
Sutta Peta. What is the meaning of Sutupitha? It includes the text of Gautam Buddha's teaching or ceremony. They are called as Sutta. Okay, so students, first of all, what is Tripitaka? Tripitaka has three pitaka, that is three part. The word pitaka means a basket, that is a collection. Okay, it means the section. The Tripitaka is written in Pali. It consists of three category of text. This is the first text, that is Sutupitaka. Okay, in this text, Gautam Buddha's teaching or sermons are there. Next, we are going to see about Vinayapitaka. Vinayapitaka. The word Vinay here means the rules. Vinayapitaka gives the rules of behavior which bhikkhus and bhikkhunis in Buddha Sangha should follow in their day-to-day life. Okay, so behavior, how to behave. Yes, so it has been clearly mentioned in Vinayapitaka. Okay. Abhidhammapitaka. Okay, students, so what is this Abhidhammapitaka? In this, Buddhist doctrine has been explained. A text title named Attakatha. Okay, actually it is an Arthakatha which explains the Tripitaka. Okay, and then learned women composed Gatha, that is narrative about their own experience. They have been compiled in Theri Gatha. All are in Pali language.
Bhagavad Gita, a sacred text of Hindu, which is a part of Mahabharata. It tells us that each one of us should do our duty without expecting reward. It also says that the path of devotion to God is open to all. Adi Shankaracharya. So let's know about Adi Shankaracharya. He lived during the 8th century CE. He emphasizes knowledge and renunciation. What is the meaning of emphasis? Emphasis means to give special importance. Yes, so he gave special importance to knowledge. And what is the meaning of renunciation? Renunciation means one no longer believe in something. Okay, so he wrote commentaries explaining Upanishad, Brahman Sutra and Bhagavad Gita. He established four math in four directions of India at Badrinath, Dwarka, Jagannathapuri and Sringeri. Okay students, उन्होंने ज्ञान और वैराग्य जैसी बातों पर बल दिया, साथ ही उपनिषदों, ब्राह्मण सूत्रों और भागवत गीता ग्रंथ पर भविष्य लिखकर भाष्य लिखकर उनका अर्थ स्पष्ट किया और उनके चार मठ थे. यस, उन्होंने भारत की चारों दिशाओं में बद्रीनाथ, द्वारिका, जगन्नाथपुरी और श्रृंगेरी स्थानों पर चार मठों की स्थापना की. वेयर डिड ही एस्टैब्लिश मठ? यस, ही एस्टैब्लिश फोर मठ्स इन फोर डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंडिया एट बद्रीनाथ, द्वारिका, जगन्नाथपुरी एंड श्रृंगेरी. स्टूडेंट्स, हु इज दिस फेमस पर्सनैलिटी? He is Kautilya. Okay, so Kautilya wrote the Arthashastra in which he discussed at length what constitute an excellent administrative system. Arthashastra in a sense, economics. Okay, now let's know more about Kautilya. Chanakya was an ancient Indian teacher, philosopher, economist, jurist, and royal advisor. He is traditionally identified as Kautilya or Vishnugupta. समझ में आ रहा है आपको? चाणक्य को ही कौटिल्य और विष्णुगुप्त नाम से संबोधित किया जाता था। हु ऑथर्ड द एंशियंट इंडियन पॉलिटिकल ट्रिटाइसिस द अर्थशास्त्र अ टेक्स्ट डेटेड टू रफली बिटवीन 3rd century BCE एंड 3rd century CE। स्टूडेंट्स, दिस फेमस पर्सनैलिटी वॉज बॉर्न इन 375 BC तक्षशिला विच इज़ नाउ इन पाकिस्तान एंड डाइड इन 283 BC विच इज़ देयर इन पाटलिपुत्र। ट्रीटाइसिस ऑन ग्रामर अष्ट अध्यायी। इट इज़ रिटन बाय द ग्रामेरियन पानिन। ही इज कंसिडर टू बी द स्टैंडर्ड वर्क ऑन संस्कृत ग्रामर। ऑन संस्कृत ग्रामर पतंजलि रोट महाभाष्य। इट एक्सप्लेन द प्रिंसिपल गिवन इन पानिन्स अष्टाध्याय। What does it explain? The principle given in the Panin Ashtadhyay. Let's know something more about Panin. Panin was an ancient Sanskrit philologist, grammarian, and a revered scholar in ancient India. Since the discovery and publication of his work by European scholar in the 19th century, Panin has been considered the first descriptive linguist and even labeled as the father of linguistics. He is known as father of linguistics. Biography of Maharishi Patanjali. He is Patanjali Rishi who wrote Mahabhashya. Student, what is this? It is a book of Mahabharat, Ramayan, which has been written by Valmiki. Arsha epics of ancient India are Ramayan and Mahabharat. Okay, the Ramayan was composed by Rishi Valmiki. So, bachcho, Ramayan kisne likhi hai? वाल्मीकि ऋषि ने। द मेन कैरेक्टर ऑफ रामायण इज श्री राम। आप सभी को पता है ना, श्री राम कौन थे? राजा दशरथ के पुत्र थे। उनकी शादी किसके साथ हुई थी? राजा जनक की सुपुत्री सीता मैया के साथ। सो आप सभी को बहुत अच्छे से पता होगा, क्योंकि इस लॉकडाउन पीरियड में रामायण और महाभारत ये दोनों एपिसोड जो है वो दूरदर्शन पे दिखाए जाते हैं। तो आपको अच्छे से पता होगा कि रामायण किसने लिखी है, श्री राम कौन थे, सीता मैया कौन थी, उनके टीचिंग्स क्या है, हमने रामायण से क्या सीखा। आप सभी को बहुत अच्छे से पता है ना? ठीक है, अब हम देखेंगे महाभारत। महाभारत हैज कंपोज्ड बाय सेज व्यास। किसने लिखी है महाभारत? व्यास ऋषि ने लिखी है। एंड इट्स मेन थीम इज द वॉर बिटवीन कौरवस एंड पांडवस। इट ऑल्सो टेल्स अस अबाउट लॉर्ड कृष्णस लाइफ। महाभारत प्रोवाइड्स अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव पिक्चर ऑफ द वेरियस ह्यूमन सेंटिमेंट्स एंड इमोशन and their consequences. Okay, students, so sometime there is such a period in the history of language, literature and arts that its glory remain undiminished even on later on. The art, literature, etc. produced in such a period is said to be classical. Raghuvansh and Kumara Sambhav is written by Kalidas. किरत अर्जुनिया इज रिटन बाय भैरवी. शिशुपाल वध इज रिटन बाय मागा. थिएटर वेर प्लेज आर कंडक्टेड. एंशियंट इंडियन थिएटर फॉर कंडक्टिंग प्लेज एंड ड्रामास. इंडिया हैज़ एन एंशियंट ट्रेडिशन ऑफ टेलिंग स्टोरी थ्रू सॉन्ग्स म्यूजिक एंड डांस. दिस आर्ट्स हैव बीन डिस्कस इन ग्रेट डिटेल इन नाट्यशास्त्र बाय भरत मुनि. गायन वादन और नृत्य के माध्यम से किसी कथा को प्रस्तुत करने की परंपरा भारत में बहुत पुरानी है. इन कलाओं की विस्तृत चर्चा भरत मुनि ने नाट्यशास्त्र ग्रंथ में की है. संवादों के माध्यम से की जाने वाली इन कलाओं की प्रस्तुति को नाटक कहते हैं. When these arts are presented with supporting dialogue, they are known as theatre. Is that clear, students? तो students, पुराने ज़माने में जो है वो रामलीला कृष्ण लीला जैसी लघु कथाएं जो हैं वो नाटक के माध्यम से इस थिएटर में बताए जाते थे. यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं छोटे मोटे जो है वो नाटक के पिक्चर्स हमने शो किए हैं, जिससे आपको पता चल जाए कि प्लेज और ड्रामास कैसे होते हैं.
भरत मुनि ठीक है वाज एन एंशिएंट इंडियन थियोरोलॉजिस्ट एंड म्यूजिकोलॉजिस्ट हु रोट नाट्यशास्त्र. इट इज़ अ थियोरोलॉजिकल ट्रिटाइसिस ऑन एंशियंट इंडियन कम्युनिकेशन इन संस्कृत लिटरेचर. भरत मुनि इज कंसिडर एज द फादर ऑफ इंडियन थियरेटिकल आर्ट फॉर्म एंड फर्स्ट कम्युनिकेशन स्कॉलर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड.
सो स्टूडेंट्स, भरत मुनि रोट नाट्य शास्त्र. संस्कृत नाटकों में खास नाटककार का लिखा स्वप्नवास दत्त और कालिदास का लिखा अभिज्ञान शकुंतलम जैसे अनेक नाटक विख्यात हैं. यस स्टूडेंट, सो दिस अभिज्ञान शकुंतल इज रिटन बाय कालिदास एक्सेट्रा आर द फेमस संस्कृत प्लेज ऑफ एंशियंट इंडिया. नरेटिव लिटरेचर्स. गुणाज्ञा भ्रुकथा इज रिटन इन लैंग्वेज कॉल्ड एज पैशची. पंचतंत्र कंपोज बाय पंडित विष्णु शर्मा. बौद्ध जकाता टेल्स आर वेल नोन. लेट्स लुक एट द अनदर टॉपिक दैट इज लाइफ ऑफ द पीपल. द लिटरेचर ऑफ एंशियंट इंडिया शेड्स लाइट ऑन द वे ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ द कॉमन पीपल ऑफ द टाइम. दोज वेर प्रॉस्परस टाइम due to the flourishing internal as well as foreign trades, the society was divided into different castes. There were organization of trader as well as artisans. These organizations were known as shrenis. Trade was carried out by sea as well as land routes. Indian goods like fine textile, ivory, precious stones, spices, beautifully made earthen potteries were in great demand in foreign countries. Main crops were rice, wheat, barley, lentil, that is masoor. The diet of the people included food items made from these besides meat, fish, milk, ghee and fruits. The people mostly wore cotton garments. Though silk and woolen garments were also worn, their clothes resemble today as dhoti, uparne, mundas, saris, etc. The concept of stitching clothes was introduced in India during the Kushana period. So students, with this I have finished my lifestyle of the people. Lifestyle of the people is very simple, in which we have seen their occupation, we have seen their clothing, their food, the important food we have seen,
all these things we have seen, how trade had been flourished, that is internal, that is trade with the internal in India as well as with the foreign countries. So this we have seen, and how caste system developed, how artisans developed their skill, everything we have seen in this topic. Okay, Indian medical science is known as Ayurveda. It is a very old tradition. It seeks to understand the symptoms of illness, its diagnosis and treatment. Symptoms क्या है बीमारी के जो लक्षण जो है बोलते हैं ना जिसे हम, वो क्या है, फिर उसके ऊपर डायग्नोसिस, उसके ऊपर क्या किया जा सकता है, उसका इलाज कैसे किया जा सकता है और उसके ऊपर ट्रीटमेंट क्या होगी. ओके, सो इन सारी चीज़ों को ध्यान में रखकर जो है वो आयुर्वेद बना हुआ है. और फिर दवाइयों को रिकमेंड किया जाता है कि यू आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम सो एंड सो प्रॉब्लम एंड यू हैव टू टेक दिस मेडिसिन. ओके, सो ऑल्सो much thought has been given to prevention of illness. Jivak, that is, Jivak was a well-known vaidya at the court of King Bimbisara. Jivak ke bare mein aapko sabko pata hoga na. He has very famous personality. The Charak Samhita contained detailed information about the clinical diagnosis and pharmacy. It is written by Charak. The famous surgeon Sushrutrata has discussed the diagnosis of different ailment and their remedies. I repeat, who was Jivak? He is Vaidya at the court of King Bimbisar. Our next question is, what does Charak Samhita contains? Charak Samhita, it contains detailed information about the clinical diagnosis and pharmacy. Okay, it contains every minute information about clinical diagnosis and pharmacy. Importance of this text is that it discusses the different causes leading to injury, fracture, their types and various type of surgeries required for them. The text was translated into Arabic language and was called as Kitab-e-Susud. It is discussed as Kitab-e-Susud. Vaghbhata also wrote many books on medical science. Ashtanga Sangraha and Ashtanga Hridaya Samhita are most important of them. The Bodh Bhikkhu Siddha Nagarjuna in his book Rasaratnakara described various chemical and metal. Then Max, that is mathematics and astronomy. In those days, how Max and how development of Max and astronomy has been developed. The ancient India had studied Max and astronomy at a great depth. Indians were the first to use number from 1 to 9 and 0. They invented the concept of decimal system in which the value of digit changes according to the place. That is ekam, daham, that is unit, tens. The value of number changes. Okay. So decimal system, that is use of point. Okay, so that is 15.2, 12.5, whatever point you are using, so that is used. And what about the numbers 1 to 9 plus 0? It has been invented by Indians. Okay, then the numbers, that is the value of digit, changes according to the place. Okay, so jo bhi number jis place pe hoga uski value change ho jayegi. Okay, the scientist Aryabhatta wrote the book Aryabhatiya, which include many formulas for mathematical operation. Aryabhatta was also an astronomer. He stated that the earth revolved around the sun. Varaha Mihir wrote a famous text, that is Pancha Siddhantika. पंच सिद्धांतिका इन 16th सेंचुरी एडी. दीज टेक्स्ट डिस्कस द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंडियन एस्ट्रोनॉमी अलोंग विद द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ एस्ट्रोनॉमी फॉर द ग्रीक रोम एंड इजिप्शियन सिविलाइजेशन. द टेक्स्ट ऑफ मैथमेटिशियन ब्रह्मगुप्त who lived in 17th century CE were translated into Arabic language. Next is, do you know Carnot? A famous one who invented atom. Okay, that is every matter is made up of smallest particle and that is said to be atom. So discovery of atom has been done by Carnot. Carnot wrote the book called as Vaisheshik Darshan. It mainly discuss Anu and Parmanu. According to Carnot, the universe is full of innumerable object. Universe mein kya hai? Brahmand mein bahut objects hai. Okay, these objects are nothing but the different forms of Anu. He said these forms might change but Anu remain unchanged. Next, centers of education. There are many famous center of education in ancient India. Students from other countries also came there for studies. First is Takshashila University. Takshashila University was an important city in ancient India trade route. Today it is in Pakistan. Archaeological excavation found there suggest that the city was established in 6th century BCE. Jivak, a contemporary of Gautam Buddha and a famous Vaidya, had studied at Takshashila. So students, Jivak has taken his education in University Takshashila. By the 4th century BCE, the fame of university has spread far and wide. Chandragupta Maurya, as the founder of the Maurya Empire, was educated at its university. The grammarian Panin and the Vaidya Charak. The grammarian Panin and the Vaidya Charak were also students of Takshashila University. The Greek historian who accompanied Alexander have also given a description of university. They have stated that such university did not exist anywhere in Greece. Okay, Greek mein nahi hai. The famous Chinese Buddha Bhikkhu Hua Huan, who came to India around 400 CE, also visits at Takshashila University. The university provided education in various subjects such as Vedic literature, Buddhist philosophy, economic, logic, etc. Varanasi. The river Ganga has two tributaries, Varuna and Ashi. The city located between them come to called as Varanasi. Jo bhi city wahan par hai, it is said to be Varanasi. Since ancient time, it has had center which provide education in the area of Vedic as well as Jain and Buddhist philosophy. Vallabhi was an ancient city in Saurashtra, that is Gujarat. From the 5th to 8th century CE, it was an important center of Jain and Buddhist philosophy. Wang Chang and Itzi, the Chinese Buddhist bhikkhus, had visited Vallabhi. Next is Nalanda University. The remains of the ancient Nalanda University can be found near today Patna city in Bihar. Emperor Harshavardhan made a generous donation to this university. According to the description of Wang Chang and It Singh, Nalanda University could accommodate thousands of students. 1000 बच्चे एक साथ पढ़ सकते हैं. Accommodate thousands of students and the library stock thousands of books. Students seeking admission to the university had to appear for an examination at the entrance gate. Seal of Nalanda Mahavir. Vikramshila University. This university was located near today Bhagalpur in Bihar. It was established by the king named Dhamrapal. In 8th century CE, it had 6 vihara, each having its own separate entrance. Next is Kanchi. During the reign of the Pallava dynasty, 6th century CE, Kanchi in Tamil Nadu emerged as an important center of education. It was a center for the teaching and learning of Vedic, Jain and Buddhist texts. Next, art and architecture. Here, Indian architecture reached its peak during the Maurya and Gupta period. The stone pillar erected by Emperor Ashok, the stone pillar erected by Emperor Ashok at various places were excellent example of Indian sculpture. The stupa at Sanchi. The stupa at Sanchi and cave sculpture at Udayagiri, Khandagiri, Kalra caves, okay, Nasik, Ajanta, Ellora, etc. show that some tradition advanced even further. The trade of making images were developed during Gupta period. Temple architecture developed during range of Chalukya and Pallava period, Pallava dynasty in South India. The temple of Mahabalipuram are the testimony to this architecture. The art of making bronze image of deities emerged during the period of Pallava. The iron pillar at Mehrauli near Delhi is evidence of advanced knowledge of metallurgy of ancient India. Thus, it is clear that ancient Indian culture was very prosperous and advanced. And in next chapter, we will be studying the India's contact with other civilization and its far-reach impact. Okay, so with this, I am finishing the topic chapter number 11. Next, we have to go with our home assignment work. Yes? Bye, students. Have a nice day.
Bronze statue at Nataraj and iron pillar at Mehrauli. Caves of Nasik. Students, next we are going to see about the stoop at Sanchi. Okay, so Sanchi is an outstanding specimen of Buddhist art and architecture. Sanchi stoop is one of the best preserved early stoop in central India. Sanchi stoop is surrounded by a railing with four carved gateway facing in all four directions. An interesting character about Sanchi stoop is that Lord Buddha has been symbolically represented by footstep, wheel, throne, etc. rather than by its own image. The Sanchi stoop is one of the most wonderful structure of ancient India.